What year is it?
Whoa, what?
What day is it? The date!
12 May, Thursday.
What year?
What year is it?
Dead Space Aftermath is a film. It's based on the Dead Space game, and I'm assuming it's connected to Dead Space because of the end stuff. But either way, when I was looking up, you know, my years later season and seeing what to do, I was like, oh, 10 years exactly since this movie came out. I was like, this is the perfect opportunity to talk about it because I have never seen it before. And I love the first two Dead Space. I haven't played the third one yet. It does not look at all interesting. So I was like, okay, this first Dead Space film, or I don't know if this is the first one, but I was like, okay, I was expecting nothing because it's a video game movie / animated. I was like, all right, this is either gonna be bad or good or in the middle. And surprisingly, I liked it. I think it's a good movie, mainly because of the gore and what and how tragic it is. And you know, it has the evil corporation. It's like, okay, that's bound to be there, like playing God. But in terms of the story of their four main protagonists telling their story throughout this mission, doing retreads and whatnot, I thought it was interesting storytelling. And within those storytelling, it's got some good kills, blood, and gore, which, you know, I love. But sort of the one main glaring issue I do have is the change in animation. So it's from this kind of awful looking 3D, not awful, but in the 3D looking animation in 2D, right, in normal, right, and then because the 3D. And then near the end, when the girl who, by the way, the character name I'm like forgetting about because they're kind of forgetful, but their arcs are interesting. When she's telling her story, it's like anime-esque, like animation. I was like, what was the creative choice behind this? Like, was it to tell like different perspectives and like the blank 3D, like animated would be how shallow or hollow the villain is trying to play God, the corporation or something? It's like, that's really weird. Like, that, I don't know who made that choice, whether it was an editing choice or an animation choice or a creative choice or whoever made the choice, producer's choice, executive choice, who knows? It just took me out just a little bit. I was like, oh, here we go, going back to 3D, the beginning, where our four main protagonists are being imprisoned. But either way, so first off, right off the bat, we get told four different perspectives. First is the black guy. I'm sorry, I don't remember their names. Where they go on his mission, right? Then he touches this rock or shard. It's a shard, and it makes him hallucinate. Starts seeing his daughter, who's been dead for years, but he misses her so much that he's willing to follow this fake daughter and do whatever he wants. So he accidentally kills one of his teammates during his mission. It causes chaos and a ruckus. And throughout the film, he does die, by the way, because he goes out in space to see his fake daughter. He misses her so much, but because of the shard, he's seen, you know, hallucinations and whatnot, right? But throughout the film, you see his sort of downward spiral of hallucinations of seeing these monsters / alien creatures killing his teammate and then putting all his teammates in danger, and then even within the end still putting his, like, he's a viable threat to his teammates to on his mission or even at their home base in space. He is sadly, you know, the one that's a hot, not hothead, but the reckless one, basically, because he's being manipulated. Which, by the way, with this shard, I love the fact that it's still like unknown in a mystery. It's clearly like, you know, manipulating all these people. Because when he does go out in space, it's like, hey, come out and kill yourself, basically. It's like, this thing's evil. And what makes it more tragic that all he wants is his daughter, but because he can't help and get past that, sadly kills up a couple of people and himself floating in space. The second perspective is the hothead guy. The other guy killed his friend, and then while he's being integrated, he's the hothead who very impulsive and being like, hey, I want to do this way. This makes sense. Again, more tragic stuff. All he wants to do after this, all of his mission, all this chaos, is to see his family, right? But because of this evil corporation or space corporation that are imprisoning them, they just kill him. He's also kind of naive and oblivious to what's really going on because he's such a hothead, right? He has tunnel vision. He cares about one thing, and it's family. And I know, honestly, his like storytelling is not at all interesting at all, if I'm being completely honest. But because he's super naive, he goes out like, yeah, I want to see my family. The two guards, or one of the guards, just shoot him in his head. He dies. And that's super sad, super tragic. Sadly, he's under a very corrupt and evil space station. The third perspective is probably my favorite in terms of like imagery. There's a lot of cool imagery because it's animated. A lot of like cool stuff being shown on screen. And this guy who has a family on a spaceship, his baby girl or baby boy was born, and he has a wife. Him and his wife have relationship issues, and you know, every time they want to talk it out, he has to go to work and whatnot. So he's doing research on this shark, and obviously he gets infected by it, and in doing so he kills his wife and his baby. I immediately knew this too. I mean, he started killing that alien creature, and then that little small baby creature is like, oh no, that's his kid and his wife. It showed that that's his kid and his goddamn wife. It's super sad because of this, you know, hallucinations and shark and whatnot. Within his story, it's shown that he see like these people floating in space and all their eyes gouged out and their mouth opens. That image, I wonder if I can find it on Google, but like, that's a cool image. I was like, hey, this looks cool. And within his story, there are actually like alien creatures. They're aliens, but they look more like creatures, but I'm gonna call them alien creatures, actually come on a space station and start killing him and his team and his boss's team and whatnot. And then the girl, the last perspective being told, she sees that he's killed his family. It's like, calls him, he's sick. And there's like a, you know, argument between the two, created us. There's like a cool, like sort of like story, or not arc, but like just saying something out loud, or just that aliens created humans or whatnot. That's an interesting little tick there. Wish they would have got more in there, but again, this is an animated movie. It's only like 90 minutes long, so it's like whatever, right? And again, this is where we see all our four main characters and their perspectives come together, kill all these alien creatures. They get away. Aftermath of the whole third perspective, where there's these aliens shooting like acid, and there's a scene of a human face getting part by acid spit from this alien. Awesome shit. I don't know if there's clips I will be shown, because this movie's so not well known. I'm assuming definitely haven't heard of it. Why should we research it? So probably we're gonna find images, but not clips or videos. But either way, that's a cool scene as well. Again, the anime art thing here, like I don't know why this wasn't the whole movie. They kept switching back to like 3D and normal 2D and the anime-esque 2D stuff. Again, super weird stuff. But either way, unlike the previous perspective, he's able to figure out, you know, what's really going on here, where the people who are playing God, they knew that they sent these people on a suicide mission, and they knew that the shower would change their memories, and they're experimenting on them to see if their memories will change how they look at reality. It's not an amazing motive for villain, but it is what it is. So unlike killing her, the big boss comes in and asks the people who are torturing them. Basically, the gist of it is don't trust anyone in this movie, because everyone is basically using each other. They'd be like, hey, join us, but she doesn't want to join. They need someone to blame, because the public will either blame this corporation or whatnot, so they need someone to blame. And they blame this girl. They blame it on her for releasing such animosity and whatnot. I guess kill her? And they don't kill her. They put her to sleep, put her in a casket, into the space casket. Then next to her name, cuts to Isaac Clarke, which I guess ties back to the games. In terms of the timeline, I don't know if this is the first or the second, or even the third game. Timeline-wise, I don't know. I don't know where this fits in. And then that's how the story ends, with the one big boss guy trying to play God, put everyone to sleep. So yeah, in the end, I was not expecting to like this movie as much as I did. Like, good blood, good kills, good gore, cool narrative, weird animation choices, typical playing God villain type person. But in the end, Dead Space Aftermath is actually good. I like it. I like this movie. And I don't know if I'll rewatch it, but it's definitely like a, this is good. People should watch it. If you're a fan of the games, just watch this, because, you know, you're not going to be mind-blown or anything. I was, because I was, you know, I had low expectations, but it's a good little, like, you know, an hour, like 90 minute to 80 minute little film that if you're a fan of the series. So that's all for Dead Space. Next, we're going back to James Bond with You Only Live Twice. So that will be in the next video. So this has been The Road So Far, and thank you for watching.